The Jersey-registered gold mining company Caledonia Mining's released its quarterly results this morning, with higher production and sales helping give its gross profit a boost. The numbers reveal healthy cash flows too, thanks to greater sales and a lower average cost of production. I'm joined on the line by President and CEO Steve Curtis. Steve, quite an improvement on previous quarters. You must be pleased.
Yes, Andrew. The improvement that we're seeing in Q2 is the result of work that's been done over many months, effectively from November 2014, which is when we implemented what we call the Life of Mine plan. And what we're seeing now is the results of the bits and pieces that were installed at the mine, in terms of a tramming loop, a six winds, a development subvertical shaft, and a decline. So yeah, it's the evidence of things coming together, which were in the plan, and we're seeing the fruits of all that hard work, which is very, very encouraging.
It is. And at the Blanket mine itself, you hit a new production record there. How did that come about?
Well, as I say, the objective of the Life of Mine plan was to increase flexibility. We require multiple stopes that we can mine from, because the Blanket mine is made up of multiple ore bodies, near vertical ore bodies, and although it's got the generic name Blanket is only one of the ore bodies, and then we've got a range of four or five additional ore bodies. So the plan that Donna Roots, our COO, put together was to improve flexibility, so that you could access tonnage from numerous places. You could also work around the grade that was realized out of the different ore bodies, and you could create a very much better profile of mining tons and grade based on what was available to you. The biggest issue that we faced in early 2015 was the inability to move additional material underground, and the introduction of what we call the tramming loop, which was a circular access on our lowest level, 22 level, enables us to move much higher tonnages. Prior to the tramming loop coming into existence, we could move about 400 tons a day, and now we're moving up to 1,200 tons a day. So that really gives you the opportunity to do development, to increase ore extraction. And what we're seeing is just a combination now of more places to mine, the ability to move more material, the ability to go and access material of different grades from different areas. And the plan is all coming together. And yes, it was a record quarter of tonnage, and we got the benefit of 12,500 ounces, which was very pleasing.
So, looking big picture, you faced a few challenges, but you're happy with where things are heading. It's been quite a transformational year, hasn't it?
Yes, it has. And again, we're working to a plan, and you can't achieve everything overnight. And at the same time, we're sinking the new central shaft, which will only come into production in 2018. So in the meantime, we have to have the ability to continue mining and grow production, so that the cash requirements of the central shaft, which is a fully funded, internally funded project, is possible. So 2016, our target is to produce 50,000 ounces, which is up on our 42,500 ounces we produced last year. And next year's target is in the region of 60,000 to 65,000 ounces. And all of that is going to come about from areas without the central shaft. So it is very transformational that this mine, above and below 750 meter level, is changing its face completely, and we will move into the new phase from 2018 onwards when we've got the new central shaft, and then we're effectively living below 750 meter level, which is our current bottom level at the moment.
So it's all sounding very promising, plenty happening. Let's just head back to your results again, which you're out this morning. The recent strengthening in the gold price, that would have helped your results.
Yes, it did. We achieved an average realized gold price of just above $1,250 an ounce, where Q1 was $1,166 an ounce. So that is very pleasing. It's all moving in the right direction. So we've got the benefit of the higher gold price, the higher production, and the beauty of that combination, and especially the higher production, is that because of the nature of Blanket Mine, it's got a higher fixed cost proportion. And as you push more and more ounces through the operation, your average cost of each one of those ounces comes down very, very nicely. And again, Q2 is demonstrating that, where our on-mine cash cost has fallen down to $629 an ounce from the Q1 of $689. So you get multiple benefits from these increases. So yeah, a very, very pleasing set of results. And the bottom line, which I'm sure shareholders will be looking at very closely, is that we've got an adjusted EPS number of 6.1 cents for the quarter compared to 2.7 cents of Q1. That is a very, very nice increase.
It is, Steve, and you're benefiting too from two new appointments. Is that right, strengthening the management team?
Well, one of them is a non-executive director. John McGloin has joined us as a non-executive director on the board. And a number of people, many people will know John from his involvement in the London market. We're very pleased that he has agreed to join our board. And we know from his past experience that he is going to be able to help us significantly with future strategic planning. And then on the actual management team, Morris Mason has joined us to be the VP of Investor Relations and Business Development. People will probably know Morris from his time as an analyst and working for stockbroking firms in the city, and we're very pleased to have him on board. So that he's a great addition to a team, and we're boosting those sort of areas in our business, because We've indicated for quite some time that our intention is to grow this business, and as Blanket develops up to a production level of 70,000-80,000 ounces a year, it will be highly cash generative, and we will be seeking opportunities to use that cash.
And Steve, this boost in confidence, has that played into your decision to increase the dividend?
Yes, the increase in the dividend is timed around the fact that the life of mine plan is successfully being implemented. So the higher production we see as being sustainable, the pieces of infrastructure that we needed to put in place have proven their value, and that has given the board the confidence to actually increase the dividend from our last payment in July by 22%, and we're very pleased to be able to share the fruits of the hard work of the additional investment of funds into the Blanket Mine, and now we can share that with our shareholders. So we're very pleased that we've been able to raise the dividend. It's been stagnant for a number of years, but the benefits flowing out of the life of mine plan have given us the confidence to be able to increase it now.
Very good, Steve. Thanks for the update. Good talking. All the best.